queuing algorithms. Queuing algorithms will be used in the quality of service process, because without having a proper algorithm, you cannot manage multiple queues in a network device. By default, we have a single queue in a network device interface, such as a router interface. But to improve the traffic quality, better to have multiple queues in an interface. Then you can identify traffic, you can prioritize traffic based on the requirements. And therefore, the queuing algorithms are really important. There are various queuing algorithms that are available, but in here we will be discussing very famous queuing algorithms that are using in most of the vendor platforms. The QoS policy implemented by the network administrator becomes active when congestion occurs on the link. First in, first out, we call FIFO. FIFO queuing buffers and forwards packets in the order of their arrival, which is the default approach. So FIFO has no concept of priority or classes of traffic, and all packets are treated equally. Weighted fare queuing. It is having an automated scheduling method that provides fair bandwidth allocation to all network traffic. In WFQ, we have different weights for different traffic types. We have high, medium, normal, low type of queues. So WFQ applies priority or weights to identify traffic, classified it into conversations or flows, and then determines how much bandwidth each flow is allowed relative to other flows. To classify traffic, WFQ will use source and destination IP addresses, MAC addresses, port numbers, protocol type, and type of service values which are coming with the PDU. And WFQ is not supporting for secure channel communication. Next queuing algorithm is class-based weighted fare queuing. When we have this class-based weighted fare queuing, within the queue we have FIFO, first in, first out. But before to that, classification will be done based on weight and the type of the class. So based on different characteristics, you can define a class such as bandwidth, weight, or maximum packet limit. And packets belongs to a class are subject to the bandwidth and queue limits, which is the maximum number of packets allowed to accumulate in the queue that characterize the class. After a queue has reached to the configured queue limit, adding more packets to the class causes tail drop. This is the default queuing response to congestion, and tail drop treats all traffic equally and does not differentiate between class of service. The last queuing algorithm that we are introducing is low latency queuing. The LLQ features brings strict priority queuing to class-based weighted fare queuing algorithm. So this is again like extension to a class-based weighted fare queuing. You have class-based weighted fare queuing in one side, in one portion, and there will be a special queue that is called PQ or priority queue. Mostly this priority queue will be allocated for voice communication. So while class-based weighted fare queuing algorithm is operating for all other traffic types, voice traffic will be treated differently in the queue management process. So LLQ allows delay-sensitive packets such as voice to be sent first. So according to the Cisco requirements, So they recommend only voice traffic be routed to the priority queue. Those are the queuing algorithms that we are introducing to you. Once you understand this, you will be getting the idea how queue management can be implemented in an interface, in a device, in a network environment to improve the quality with this prioritization process.